Don't lose your sense of instinct. Don't lose your gut sense of what plays and what doesn't. And don't rely on statistical analysis or a big machine to compile data to help inform your creative process.
This is Jon Favreau, who's writer, producer, director, and actor, as well as the owner of his own production company, Fairview Entertainment. He has a nice net worth of over $60 million, and I'm sure some of you know him as one of three godfathers of what is probably the most successful franchise around right now. But I'll get to this later. Favreau was born on October 19, 1966. He's a true New Yorker born in Queens to two schoolteacher parents. Sadly, though, Favreau's mother did pass away in 1979 due to a battle with leukemia. Favreau went to high school and college in New York, although he ultimately dropped out of college and moved to Chicago in 1988. Favreau aspired to be a comedian and would perform at local improv theaters such as the Improv Institute and Improv Olympic. He tried his hand at comedy until... After a few auditions, Favreau landed his first major acting gig in the beloved football flick, Rudy. Also, this is where he met the one and only Vince Vaughn. Favreau appeared to have finally made it, but even though this was a major milestone for him, he still struggled to find work. He was featured in a few minor roles here and there. He even managed to land a role on Seinfeld as a clown. His career was stagnant, and he knew he had to change this.
Jon Favreau was tired of going to movie auditions and facing rejection, so he decided to write his own script, find a director, and have his struggling actor friends fill the roles they inspired.
Swingers, directed by Doug Liman and written by Favreau himself. This was his true entrance to Hollywood. Rudy was just the vehicle that got him there. With Swingers was his in. He made it. But before he found his success in Swingers, Favreau had to shop his script all over town. He got all of his actor buddies together, and he did table reads for every major studio that he could find. Sure enough, a surprise studio scooped up the project. This studio was none other than Miramax. This was one of the biggest studios around at the time. Favreau was enamored with Miramax. Having Miramax behind him made Favreau a favorite around the town. From here on out, Favreau continued to act, produce, and direct in a number of projects. This includes films like Maid, where he would work with his buddy Vince Vaughn again, as well as the audience favorite Elf. Jon also featured in a few films like Ben Affleck's Daredevil, Something's Gotta Give, and again with his pal Vince Vaughn in The Breakup. Favreau also made one of my childhood favorites, Zathura. Zathura was all but a stepping stone to what would be his entrance into the zeitgeist. Favreau proved himself as a major director with this one. He managed to shoot a film with an unfinished script, a sketchy actor who was at the time unbankable, and a worthless IP, and he turned this into what is known as the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Favreau literally found the secret to turning thread into gold with this one. At the time, Iron Man was a monstrous success, going on to earn $585 million. Favreau jumpstarted a billion-dollar franchise, not just the MCU, but as for the character of Iron Man alone. From Rudy of 93 to Swingers of 96, Favreau made a name for himself. Then from 1996 to 2007, Favreau tried to maintain his success from Swingers, but once Iron Man came out, he hit his true big break. From 2008 on, Favreau continued to work hard, appearing in multiple films, some including his pal Vince Vaughn again. Favreau also directed the Iron Man sequel, where he stretched his role as Tony Stark's bodyguard, Happy Hogan, as well as managing to earn Marvel over $600 million. Favreau also directed and produced the sci-fi film Cowboys and Aliens. It may not have done well both financially and critically, but he endured. Favreau left the Iron Man franchise, only staying on to act and executive produce Iron Man 3 and future Avengers film. In 2014, he went back to his indie roots and made the culinary family comedy Chef. This was a nice refresher in Favreau's career as he went back to what he knew. The film did fairly well in the indie box office. Chef also won over the hearts of many critics. After Chef, Favreau went back to the big time, and he was hired to be the director by Disney for their new live-action Jungle Book remake. Favreau proved himself yet again to be a great filmmaker with his creative technological wonder. Jungle Book grossed under just $1 billion, and like with Chef, Jungle Book had extremely positive reviews. Favreau has truly proven himself as a wonderful filmmaker, entertainer, creator, and of course artist. Over the years, he's managed to launch a couple billion-dollar franchises, as well as jumpstart his own career, Vince Vaughn's career, and of course, Robert Downey Jr.'s career. Favreau is now directing one of Disney's crown jewels, The Lion King. It's a live-action remake. He's also working on a sequel to the live-action Jungle Book he did in 2016. Favreau also has recently been announced to write a new TV show on the Disney streaming platform for none other than the Star Wars franchise. Supposedly, he's still also working on a Disneyland Night at the Museum-type movie called Magic Kingdom, which takes place in one of the Disney parks. Favreau has not done too bad in his career. He truly is a jack-of-all-trades in the industry. There is no denying his skill. He's an expert in movie making, and the future for him looks to only hold more success.